Hello everyone, and welcome to Fallout 3. This is a new series that I am going to start right now, so, you know, should be fun. I never really got into the whole Fallout thing. I mean, I played New Vegas, but I've never played Fallout 3. I've seen bits and pieces, and I've seen my friend play bits and pieces, but, you know. So, let's get started.
I don't want to set the world on fire. I just want to start a flame in your heart. In my heart, I have but one desire. And that one is you, no other will do. I've lost all ambition for worldly acclaim. I just want to be the one you love. And with your admission that you feel the same, I'll have reached the goal I'm dreaming of. Be complete. I
war. War never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first discovered the killing power of rock and bone, blood has been spilled in the name of everything from God to justice to simple psychotic rage. In the year 2077, after millennia of armed conflict, the destructive nature of man could sustain itself no longer. The world was plunged into an abyss of nuclear fire and radiation. But it was not, as some had predicted, the end of the world. Instead, the apocalypse was simply the prologue to another bloody chapter of human history. For man had succeeded in destroying the world. But war never changes. In the early days, thousands were spared the horrors of the Holocaust by taking refuge in enormous underground shelters known as vaults. But when they emerged, they had only the hell of the wastes to greet them. All except those in Vault 101. For on that fateful day, when fire rained from the sky, the giant steel door of Vault 101 slid closed and never reopened. It was here you were born. It is here you will die. Because in Vault 101, no one ever enters, and no one ever leaves.
Well, I'm just a baby.
Are you a boy or a girl?
Why are you fucking asking me? All right, so we got a little bit of the backstory there from Slade from Teen Titans. So son, that's Catherine, pretty cool.
A beautiful, healthy baby boy.
Oh, James, we did it. A son, a beautiful son.
You've got a bright future ahead of you, son. I'm sure of it.
How do you know? You didn't even know what Look sex I was.
Hi there. I'm your daddy, little guy.
Oh, you're my dad?
Daddy.
Oh, this is going to be a great relationship.
You need a name, aren't you? Your mother and I have been talking. What do you think about...
Shit. Player name. Hell no. Let's do with, what's a good name? That's my name.
That's a good name, don't you think? Fits you perfectly. Looks like they've finished the gene projection. Let's see.
Get that floating TV out of my face. Oh, God. That's how I look like? Okay. Let's go with Caucasian. Caucasian. Is it next? Oh, what the fuck? Oh, what the fuck? Done. Are you sure you want to have this to be your character? Yes.
You're going to look a lot like your dad. See that, Catherine?
Oh, very strapping.
You know, I can barely fucking see. I don't know if that's like the same for everything, but I can't see. Ooh, yeah, difficulty. Display. Brightness, there we go. Right there. That's good. Didn't change a thing.
It's a big world out there, son. Full of all sorts of people. What about you? What kind of person are you going to be?
You're just...
Catherine?
James?
Catherine!
Uh-oh.
She's in cardiac arrest. Start compressions. Get the baby out of here. Move! 1,000. 2,000. Come on.
No!
Hang on.
Mama!
Hang on.
Mother!
We need a doctor, not a dead man. Fail to meet my expectations and there will be troubles. James and his cheery chatter.
Decorations.
May your future be bright.
Don't look straight into the light now. Just like her eyes. It's just something you get used to, don't you?
Mother knew what sex I was.
Come on over here, son. Come on. Walk to daddy.
What you want, Dad?
There you go.
I look nothing like you.
Goodness.
You look much better than me. Get out of here.
Looking like a pro. Your mother would have been so proud. Listen, kiddo. I know you don't like it when daddy leaves you alone, but I need you to take care of yourself for a minute. You just stay here while daddy runs to his office. You'll be okay, pal. I'll be back in a bit.
He just called me pal. He's not my father. Give me the shit. Oh my gosh, that's adorable. Alright, I guess I can figure out the controls. Can I? I can jump! Ha! A little baby jump. Ha! Give me your guy. Alright. Open that shit up because I'm a genius. What's this? This a book? Yeah. Can I play with some toys? Can I? I can't. Fuck. Come on, book. You're special. Right trigger. S is for strength, and that means I am strong. I can carry more toys and swing stuff all day long. Okay, so I'm pretty sure that stands for carrying equipment and melee weapons. I think I'm going to be more of a marksman in this game, so what's the smallest? Okay, I'll keep this at a 4. I'm going to do 4. Okay. I can just do 10 and that's it. I'll do 3, actually. P is for perception, a long, funny word. It means what I tasted, smelled, saw, and heard. 3. E is for endurance, and that's how long I can play. I'm always really healthy and have energy all day. Let's keep that as 5. C is for charisma. It's why people think I'm great. I make my friends all laugh and smile and never want to hate. That's like me. I'll have a 7 for that. I is for intelligence. It means I'm really smart. I use my brain for lots of stuff, like science, math, and art. 7. A is for agility, and that's how I get around. I move really fast and easy, and I never make a sound. That's for sneak, obviously. Sure. L is for luck, and it's simple, you see. It means that good things always happen to me. Motherfucking 8. No, kidding. Let's do 6. 6 on that one. Oh, I can just do that. Okay, 2 points to go. There we go. To grab a toy from the toy box, look at it and press right stick. You're fucking mine. Oh, you son of a bitch. I said you're mine and you're coming with me. Dad, I'm out of my cage. Holy shit! Okay, nope, nope. I didn't go anywhere.
Quite the little explorer, aren't you?
I didn't go anywhere. I was playing with my ball. Trying to pin you
in. Come on over here. I want to show you something.
Adorable.
See that? It was your mother's favorite passage. It's from the Bible, Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. She always loved that. All right, come on. Let's go see if your little friend Amada wants to play.
Want to know my favorite verse from the Bible? Vengeance is mine! And it will be. Come at me, Dad. Motherfucker. Ah, I'm child. Dad. Oh, what the hell? What the hell? 9 years later, okay. So, I'm 10. Cool, I really enjoy this so far. This is fun. Dad has a beard now.
Happy birthday.
So much clapping coming from 3 people.
Happy birthday, pal. I can't believe you're already 10.
I know, it seems like 2 seconds ago there was a white light and I was 1 again.
I don't have to tell you how special this day is, do I?
Nope.
Down here in Vault 101, when you turn 10, well, you're ready to take on your first official vault responsibility. So here you are. As overseer, I hereby present to you your very own Pip-Boy 3000. Get used to it.
Jealous, Dad?
Your first work assignment tomorrow.
Are you jealous?
Enjoy your party. You're only 10 once, so have fun.
Hey!
Oh, happy birthday! We really surprised you, didn't we?
Yeah!
Your dad was afraid you were onto us. But I told him not to worry. You're so easy to fool.
You didn't fool me! I just pretended not to know. Great party, Amata. Amata? A-M-A-T-A. Amata. Thanks for doing this for me. Is this it? Or hasn't the party started yet? Great party.
You're welcome. But really, your dad did most of it. I just helped with the decorations and stuff.
Oh, did you?
Hey, I bet you can't guess what I got you for your birthday. Go on, guess.
I really have no idea. A date with Christine. Kendall. Just give me the present already. Well, I'm not going to be an ungrateful little shit.
I knew I surprised you. Who's your favorite barbarian? That's right, Grognak. Issue 14. And with no missing pages. I found this in a box of my father's old things. Believe it or not. Imagine him reading comic books. I guess everybody was 10 once. Well, I better let you get back to mingling with your guests. We'll talk later, okay? Happy birthday.
Don't you dare say that. Don't you dare say that. Comics are lifeless.
Enjoying yourself?
Yeah.
Happy birthday, Sonny.
Thank you. Why don't you pay attention to me? It's my birthday. Stop drinking. Why do we have an old man drinking alone? At my birthday party.
Attention, everyone.
Ooh, grandma.
Nice kid, boy. What is that? One of the 3,000
What you looking at?
This party's pretty good, I guess. For a little kid. Balloons, party hats. Not as cool as my party, though. Remember how my dad got Andy to do magic tricks? And we all played Hunt the Mutant in the atrium? Oh, right. You weren't invited to my party. Too bad, man. It was really fun.
Man, sit your ass down, Kanye West.
Yeah, I just wanted to say, this party's pretty good, but it wasn't as bad as... Shut the fuck up.
Asshole.
Hey, thanks for inviting me. Really cool party and everything.
You seem cool.
I know that, Butch and I give you a hard time, but you don't take that seriously, right?
Oh, no, of course not.
Anyway, happy birthday and everything. I better get back to, you know.
To you know what? Am I too cool to know what you do? I will jump on your face.
Yeah, Paul.
Fuck your time at this party.
Your new best friend.
Who do you mean, dork face?
Go on,
shut your fucking mouth.
Dork face.
What a little shit.
How do you like that Pip-Boy, son? Fit all right and everything?
It's really cool. Did you fix it up for me? It's all right. Seems kind of old, though. I hate it. How do I get it off? Well, he said my Pip-Boy was a piece of junk. Well, I'm not going to be a dick or a little bitch,
matter of fact,
so
I did.
I'll just be grateful.
It. Some may think the A-series is a bit basic, but I've always preferred them for their reliability.
Thanks, Stanley.
Don't mention it. Oh, yes, I almost forgot. Happy birthday. Not much, but I hope you like it.
How's it going,
Pat? I got two fucking presents from one dude. Hey, thanks, Dad. Thanks for getting me stuff. Hey, Dad, thanks for getting me a lot of fucking presents, Dad.
Having a good time.
Great.
Nonsense. I hope you appreciate the effort, Amato.
Oh, wait, he's the guy that gave me the Pip-Boy. Never mind.
She really seems to like you, for some reason.
Of course she likes me. I'm a real charming guy. I mean, didn't you see me 9 years ago? All my charisma points? That's where they went to. She did a great job, but couldn't have helped out a bit more. Okay, I'll be the
Don't
first one.
Don't presume too much on her friendship, young man. I'm still the overseer, and I'm still in charge of this vault and everyone in it.
Look at my face. Does it look like I give a fuck?
What do you think we should call?
Are you having a nice party? 10 years old. My, my, my. Seems like only yesterday that your daddy came. Goodness, listen to me ramble. You're waiting for your present, aren't you?
You said one sentence. I'm not bored at all. Yes, ma'am.
Such a nice, polite young man you are.
Thank you.
Don't ever lose your gift to speaking your mind so directly. We could use more of that down here.
Oh, don't worry. Ha!
Here you go. A nice sweet roll that I baked for you just this morning. And it's all for you. You're the birthday boy. No sharing required today.
No way. Sweet roll added, motherfucker.
Get it?
To bring up your Pip-Boy, push B. I'm all health. I'm all happy, healthy, wealthy, and wise. Okay. Do I talk to you again?
Why are you still hanging?
I'm hungry, and that stupid robot destroyed the cake. Give me that sweet roll you got from old Lady Palmer.
How about this? You can go fuck yourself. Sure, Butch, spit on the wheat roll and give it to him. Yes, here you go.
I don't want your nerd cooties. You're gonna be sorry you did that. We'll see how tough you are later when the grown-ups aren't around.
Do something now, punk ass.
Butch is such an idiot. Just ignore him.
Don't worry about me. I'm not scared of him. I wouldn't give him what he wanted. He says he's going to make me sorry later. Your dad's the overseer. Can't you talk to him about Butch? Okay, so there's confidence, weasel, and just outright bitch. So, confidence.
I know. He thinks he's so tough. One of these days, we'll figure out a way to get him back, okay?
I'm gonna hold you to it. You hear that? You hear that, cockmouth? We're coming after you. Can I swing at you? No? Wait, so this robot destroyed the cake?
Ooh.
It used this giant saw, huh? I bet it did. Who do I talk to? I'm done with my birthday party. Dad!
Hey, that was Jonas on the intercom. He and I have been cooking up a little surprise present. Jonas is waiting for you downstairs on the reactor level. Go ahead. I don't think anyone will mind if you slip out for a few minutes.
Better not. I'm the birthday boy. I can do whatever the hell I want.
To keep in touch with the young people, you know, as part of my job. Plus, well, I like.
The flashing arrows on your compass show the location of your objective. Oh.
Happy birthday, dearie. My goodness. I hope I didn't miss the party.
Who the fuck are you? Yeah, my dad and Emeta threw me a great party, didn't they? I'm not a girl, and I'm not five. Stop calling me dearie. Yes, can I have my present now?
They sure did. My, my. 10 years old already? Why, I can remember helping your dad change your diapers.
That's disturbing.
And now look at you. A great big grown-up 10-year-old with your very own Pip-Boy. Since this was such a special occasion,
yeah, I'm ready for these!
I wrote you a poem. Just for you. I hope you like it.
Thank you. I will treasure it always. Is that all? Thanks, I guess. Did you get me anything else? A poem! You've got to be kidding me. Okay.
Of course. Run along now, dearie, and have yourself a wonderful birthday.
Miss?
Thank you.
Nice chatting with you. Lobby's open. Thanks again for coming.
This way. Can I run? Can I not run? Okay. Oh.
Vault-Tec water.
I can't. I can't see what I look like. I have no idea where I'm going. Hey.
Sounds like everybody's having a good time in there.
What are you looking at? It's just looking at the ground. Sounds like everybody's having a good time. Wonder why I wasn't invited.
Enjoy the party, sir?
Because you're creepy as fuck. I only showed up because Amada's friends with the rat. Oh, you motherfucker. I only showed up because that little kid I don't care about, really. Yeah, dick.
What are you doing down here, young man? I thought kids weren't allowed down on the reactor level.
Hey, I'm not a kid. I'm 10 years old. Hell yeah.
You sure are. Pip-Boy and everything. Look at that. If you can wait just one more minute, I think your dad will want to give you the surprise himself.
Sure. Sure. Come on, dinner. Nope. No, I'm kidding.
Are you ready for your surprise?
I am Liam Neeson. What kind of surprise? I don't like surprises.
The Overseer gave you your Pip-Boy, and you're old enough to do some work, so I figure you're old enough for this. Your own BB gun. It's a little old, but it should work perfectly. Jonas found it down here. It was in pretty rough shape. Took us a good 3 months to find the parts to get it working again. You know how tough it is to find a spring that small?
Hold the phone. It took you 3 months to fix a BB gun? No wonder Mom died.
Good thing Butch misplaced that switchblade of his. So, what do you think? Want to give it a try?
Here? We can't shoot a gun here. What do I get to kill? Let's do that
one. We sure can't, unless we want the Overseer beating down our door. Jonas and I have found a place, though. Come on.
Alright, can I leave you, Dad? Yeah, okay. How do I pull up the gun? Let's see. B. Status, special skills, perks, general. How do I pull up my gun? Oh, there we go. Let's go find Butch! Can't open it. Fuck! Alright, put my gun away. Gun. How do I put it away?
Well, what do you think? You can come down here and shoot anytime you want.
Sounds great. Thanks, Dad. This is great. Thanks.
Sure. Couldn't have done it without Jonas's help. You make sure to thank him.
Oh, I shall. Pew! What? Pew! Can I not fire at that? Pew! There we go. I can't go past this line. Oh, yeah, I can. Oh, I can't? What? Bang. Oh. Yes, I can. Radroche. Mother. You motherfucker.
Good work. That's one less Radroche to deal with. Let's get a picture together. Capture the moment. Hey, Jonas. Get a picture of me with the big game hunter.
Smile.
That's awesome. Oh no, the white transition!
Anyway, so I'm the Overseer's daughter, so what?
6 years later.
Revelation 21:6. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. As far as I can tell, you're a perfectly healthy 16-year-old boy.
Okay, so you had me scared there. I thought that thing was gonna start vibrating, because I would have had to freak out.
Well, now, you've got a goat to take.
What? If you say so, Dad. But I'm really sick. Anything I need to know about the goat? Yes.
The generalized occupational aptitude test.
Okay, aptitude test. I got it. Don't need to know anymore. If you say so, Dad.
It's not my call. Those are the rules. You're 16 now, so this year you take the goat. Come on, it's not so bad. Everyone has to...
Can I just leave? Bye, Dad.
Take care, son. Now get out of here, and good luck.
That guy really sounds like Liam Neeson. Okay, this way. Let's go take the goat!
Good morning. Stopped in to see the old
Hey, it's good to see you.
Class,
haven't changed
right?
in 6 years. Get the goat class, talk to Mr. Botch. Ooh.
Snake, Amata.
Oh, what the hell?
God, Butch, why don't you just leave me alone?
Hey.
Hey, look. It's Smart Mouth. Afraid I ain't got time for your fancy words right now. So beat it.
You beat it. Off. On your face. Hey. It's none of my business. It's just like, hey. You're fucking right. I'll see you later. Tunnel snakes? You guys look like... Yo, you guys are some kind of gang? Is that it? Pity. I could be a smart mouth. Sure.
Damn right. And you'll stay out of our way if you know what's good for you. No one messes with the tunnel snakes. Especially not this stuck-up little daddy's girl.
Look at her face. She's just like your fucking face. It's just like... She looks so disgusted. It's hilarious. Leave her alone, or you'll answer to me. Maybe I can help. She's very sensitive about her height or weight. No. If you keep messing with her, the overseer is going to come down on your gang.
Maybe you're right. We can deal with her later. Come on, tunnel snakes. This little bitch isn't worth our time.
Oh, what a cock.
Whatever you say, Butch.
Can I?
You're the boss. Tunnel snakes rule.
Hey, Susie.
Nah.
That's fine. Let's go.
Are you okay?
Thanks for getting rid of them. Assholes. I don't know why they won't leave me alone. Just because my father's the overseer, I guess? Idiots.
Oh, not much.
Anything else? Okay. Peter's on the fritz again. Where am I going? Where am I going? Where's my objective? Didn't right
you...
in here.
Well, you made it. All set for the goat? Trust me, it really isn't that bad. Just something everybody has to go through.
Oh, I'm feeling kind of sick, Mr. V. Guess I'll have to reschedule. Sure, I'm ready. I bet I'll ace it. Come on! I don't really have to take this stupid test, do I? Sure.
I'm sure you will, especially since it's multiple choice with no wrong answers. We'll start as soon as everyone's found a seat. Good luck.
He has successfully made me sound like a dumbass.
Yes.
As soon as everyone takes their seats, we can get started.
Alright, can I just sit anywhere? How do I look?
Well,
who said that?
Classroom, we can finally get started.
I can't.
No talking, and keep your eyes to yourselves. Yes, I'm talking to you, Mr. Deloria.
Sure thing, Mr. Brotch.
Unless anyone else has an insightful comment, let's get started. Question one. A frenzied vault scientist runs up to you and yells, I'm going to put my quantum harmonizer in your photonic resonation chamber. What's your response?
But doctor, wouldn't that cause a parabolic disabilization of the fusion singularity? yep.
Question two. While working as an intern in the clinic, a patient with a strange infection in his foot stumbles through the door. The infection is spreading at an alarming rate, but the doctor stepped out for a while. What do you do?
Amputate the foot before the infection spreads, scream for help, medicate the infected area to the best of your abilities, restrain the patient, and merely observe as the infection spreads. No. Medicate the infected area to the best of your abilities. Sure.
Question three. You discover a young boy lost in the lower levels of the vault. He's hungry and frightened, but also appears to be in possession of stolen property. What do you do?
Give the boy a hug and tell him everything will be okay as you stab him in the neck. Confiscate the stolen property by force and leave the boy there as punishment. Pick the boy's pocket to take the stolen property for yourself and leave him to his fate. lead the boy to safety and then turn him into the overseers. This one.
Question four. Congratulations. You've made one of the Vault 101 baseball teams. Which position do you prefer?
Pitcher, catcher, designated, hitter, none. You wish the Vault had a soccer team. Hell no. Hate soccer. Designated hitter.
Question five. Your grandmother invites you to tea, but you're surprised when she gives you a pistol and orders you to kill another Vault resident. What do you do?
What the fuck? Obey the elder and kill the resident with the pistol? Offer your most prized possession for the resident's life? Ask Granny for a magnum instead. After all, you don't want to miss. Throw your tea in Granny's face. Okay, none of these are good. Offer your most prized possession for the resident's life. Yes.
Question six. Old Mr. Abernathy has locked himself in his quarters again, and you've been ordered to get him out. How do you proceed?
God damn it, Abernathy. Use a bobby pin to pick lock the door.
Question seven. Oh no, you've been exposed to radiation, and a mutated hand has grown out of your stomach. What's the best course of treatment?
A blow to the brain? A large dose of anti-mutagen agent? Prayer? Maybe God will spare you in exchange for a life of pious devotion? Removal of the mutated tissue with a precision laser? Anti-mutagen? Let's see, I'm not a doctor, so that's not a good idea. And I'm not a doctor, so that's not a good idea. But I guess that one. I could ask someone.
A fellow Vault 101 resident is in possession of a Grognak the Barbarian comic book, issue number one.
I have that.
You want it?
I have that.
What's the best way to obtain it?
Trade the comic book for one of your own valuable possessions, steal the comic book at gunpoint, sneak into the resident's quarters and steal the comic book for his desk, slip some knockout drops into the resident's Nuka-Cola, and take the comic book when he's unconscious. Trade the comic book for your own possessions.
Question nine. You decide it would be fun to play a prank on your father. You enter his private restroom when no one is looking and
loosen the bolts of some pipes when he's when the sink is turned on, the restroom will be flooded. Put a firecracker in the toilet, that's sure to cause some chaos. Oh god. Break into the locked medicine cabinet and replace his high blood pressure medication with sugar pills. Wow. Manipulate the power wattage of his razor so he'll get an electric shock the next time he shaves. Okay, let's just do fucking that one. That's like the most harmless.
Who is indisputably the most important person in Vault 101? He who shelters us from the harshness of the atomic wasteland and to whom we owe everything we have, including our lives.
Okay.
Pencils down, people. That's it. The infamous goat. I'm sure most of you didn't find it so bad. Others, well, there are always openings in the maintenance department. Don't forget to hand in your test before you leave. You don't want to know what happens to people who fail the goat. You can have the rest of the day
off
to
wrong
celebrate
answers.
Or to pray, as the situation warrants.
Back off.
Okay. Now, I heard from a friend that you can actually talk to him.
Hello.
Wow. It says here you're going to be the Vault's marriage counselor.
No, I'm not.
Almost makes me want to get married, just to be able to avail myself of your services.
Don't be a kiss ass. Wow, that's what I've always wanted to be. My dreams are finally coming true. Whatever. I just answered randomly. Is that how you got stuck with your job? Oh. Snap! That can't be right. The stupid test got it all wrong.
Listen. I was just as obnoxious at your age. I didn't take the goat seriously. Look where I ended up. Just between you and me, the whole test is a joke. If you don't like the results, I can make your goat come out any way you want.
Oh, hell yeah. Okay. Reset. Okay. I'm going to do this last part, then we're going to end it here. So, I'm going to do barter. Let's see, what's big guns? Okay, big gun skill determine your combat effectiveness with all oversized weapons, such as Fat Man, Missile Launcher, Flamethrower, Minigun, and Gatling Laser. No. Small guns. Small guns determines your effectiveness with all conventional projectile weapons, such as 10mm pistol, BB gun, assault rifle, and combat shotgun. But they don't have, like... Okay, whatever. Small guns. Speech. You know, we don't really have to do barter that much, because speech kind of does that. Lockpick. Yes. Done. Cool. All right, so I think that'll do it for this episode.
Hope I did okay.
Did pretty good. So this game looks really, 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 really fun. I can tell I'm going to have a good time with it. And there's a staring competition going on here.
Get out of my face.
You shut the fuck up. You yeah, I would punch you if I knew that there was going to be no consequences. I think you can fight him later, maybe. Hi. How you doing? Because, little girl, I think you're a fucking retard, and I thought you needed my assistance. Asshole. Okay, so... Oh, shit. All right, I guess at the end of this,
You need to know...
Wake up! Come on, wake up!
I'm not going to be around to hold your hand forever.
Okay, wait! Shush! Damn it, I can't fucking save.
Come on, you've got to wake up.
Huh, what's wrong?
You've got to get out of here.
Your dad is in this
room. Your dad is gone, and my father's men are looking for you.
Why? What do you mean my dad is gone?
He's left the vault. I don't know how, but he's gone. And my father, he's kind of gone crazy.
Good. I've never seen you so scared. Amata, what's happened?
It's Jonas. They killed him. My father's men. They took him and... Oh my.
I have no idea who Jonas is. Oh my god! Are you okay? You're not going to cry, are you? So they killed Jonas, and I'm next, is that it?
Yeah. Don't worry about me. I'm just sorry you had to find out like this. I know Jonas.
I didn't even talk to the guy.
But we've got to go now. My father's men will be here any minute.
My dad can't have left the door sealed shut. I need to escape the vault, and you're going to help me.
Not anymore.
Apparently, but the honestly...
Are you honestly telling me you had no idea your dad was leaving? He really didn't tell you?
No. No. I had no idea he was planning to leave.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sure he had his reasons. Maybe Jonas was supposed to explain everything to you?
I don't know, bitch.
But it doesn't matter. I can help you escape. I have my own plan.
I honestly knew my dad wasn't going to have that great of a connection to me when he called me pal. When I was one, he was like, hey, pal. I'm like, fuck you too, dad. Escape the vault? How?
Listen, there's a secret tunnel that leads directly from my father's office to the exit. You'll have to hack the computer in his office to open it. Use these to get into his office. That's how I...
Sounds like a good plan. Let's get out of here.
Oh, one more thing. I stole my father's pistol. I hope you won't need it, but you'd better take it just in case.
Good thing I did small arms. Thanks, Amata. I will only use it at last resort, I promise.
Okay, I'll try.
Fingers crossed.
Watch out for security. Good luck.
Okay, this is where I save it. So yeah, seems pretty fun. And yeah, I did actually play a little bit with a friend. He was just showing me the ropes and stuff, didn't play very far, but yeah. So, all right. So I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please be sure to rate the video, comment, and subscribe if you got the fucking balls. And yeah, I will see you all in the next video. Take care.